In this video, we will go through all parts of the Geologic Map GIS template provided by Astrogeology to NASA-funded mappers producing USGS scientific investigation maps, known as SIM-series maps, and provide a brief explanation of how they work together to support the entire mapping process. The actual contents of each project are based on the specifications of the mapping coordinator's letter of support for that map, but a generic version of the package is also available for download at the Planetary Geologic Mapping Program Guidelines website. The README is a text file stored in the root of the project directory that details all the information contained in that project and should be the first place mappers look for clarification. It also includes basic guidelines for using the data and contact information for technical support. The first folder, labeled Coordinate Systems, contains one or more projection files that define the spatial reference of the project. A projection file is simply a text file with a PRJ extension that defines the spatial domain or body, projection type, and the parameters for that projection. These coordinate systems are already saved in the map document and written to all spatial data in the project, but can be useful in recreating the map or sharing with collaborators. Layer files are used to save the symbology of a layer in a map outside of the map document. They do not contain any of the source data and only work with ArcMap MXDs. The layer files provided in these templates are used to set the symbology of the empty feature classes, which include geologic contacts, linear features, location features, and surface features based on FGDC standard symbology. The Rasters folder contains all base maps and key supplemental data approved for use in the mapping process. They are clipped to the map boundary and projected in the map coordinate system. This folder also includes the ancillary files that contain the spatial reference, statistics, overviews, and metadata associated with each image. The working folder is where all mapping data are stored, and we recommend keeping this as the repository for all in-progress work, notes, and graphics related to the GIS. It is important to keep this workspace as well organized as possible, since intermediate and derivative files can quickly become cluttered. The shapefiles folder is not included in the generic template, but is included for prepared projects and typically just contains the shapefile of the map boundary, which can be useful for sharing, clipping, and recreating maps. The geodatabase contains all map features and mosaic dataset if there is one. Geodatabases allow users to leverage the most capability in a GIS environment, some of which will be covered here. For more information on using a file geodatabase, see our other video tutorials or visit Esri's website for detailed documentation and exercises. Within the geodatabase is a feature data set, which acts like a subfolder for all data that share a common spatial reference and tolerance. This means that any feature class imported or exported from the feature data set will automatically be projected with that coordinate system, which can be accessed or modified through the feature data set properties window. Stored in the feature dataset are the feature classes which store the actual mapping data. We recommend that you output all derivative layers to the same space and use a naming convention that supports version control. As mentioned, there are a number of advantages to managing your spatial data in a geodatabase, and one of the most helpful is the attribute domain. Attribute domains are predefined values which can be text, numeric ranges, or dates that are available as drop-down field attributes. The template geodatabase comes pre-populated with coded domains for all feature types used by the layer files and feature classes, greatly reducing the number of errors and overall time when entering attributes. All prepared projects include MXDs saved in versions 10.1, 10.3, and 10.4. In the event that the map is corrupted, it may be recovered from an earlier version or rebuilt using the elements covered here. Thank you for viewing. We hope this video has been helpful. For more videos, as well as tools and resources for planetary GIS, visit the Mercator GIS Lab, hosted by the USGS Astrogeology Science Center in Flagstaff, Arizona.